you've played sci-fi games or watched sci-fi movies, one thing most of them have in common is this wireframe scanning effect. And today I'm going to show you how to make this wireframe scanning effect in Blender. Okay, we have our default scene in Blender. I'm just gonna do it in the default cube. I'm gonna extrude this a little, scale it down like that, and extrude this a little. Let's scale it down like that. Now I'm gonna be selecting it and subdividing it. Maybe four times. Yeah, that looks good. Yeah, four times looks good. Now we have all this geometry. And I'm gonna duplicate it, and I'm gonna add a modifier, which is the wireframe modifier. I'm gonna disable the overlay so that I can see it clearly. And now I'm gonna bring out the thickness to something that I like, and I like this. Yeah, I like this. Maybe 0.001. Sorry, 0.01. I'm gonna select the original cube again, and I just realized that I didn't start this. I'm gonna duplicate that again, and this one is gonna be just like that. I'm gonna name these right now. I'm gonna name this original cube as original, the cube one, which is the wireframe, as the wireframe. And I'm gonna rename this as I don't know, in between, because it's gonna be in between the wireframe and the original. Now I'm gonna add in a cube. I'm gonna scale it up like that, and scale it down along the x-axis like that. Now we're gonna be scanning this cube from here to here. So let's do that. I'm gonna select the wireframe first, and I'm gonna add in a boolean modifier. Sorry, a boolean modifier. I'm gonna select this, and we can see that we've done the opposite of what we want to achieve actually. Now we want the cube to, I mean, we want the wireframe to be visible only in the area where the cube is, and not in every place except where the cube is. So we're gonna change the operation to intersect, and now we can see that the wireframe is displayed only where the cube is. Do the same for the in between. I'm gonna add a boolean modifier inside it to intersect and select the cube, and select our original mesh. I'm gonna add an a boolean modifier for that, and we need difference for that, and select the cube. And now you can see that we don't have it where the cube is. And now let's bring up our timeline. I'm gonna bring this cube like say over here. Yeah, and I'm gonna add in a keyframe over there. Let's go to frame 100 maybe, and I'm gonna make this x value positive, and I'm gonna add in a keyframe over there, and I'm gonna change the interpolation mode to linear so that it doesn't slow down at the end. Now if you see, well, our cube is moving, but we can't really see anything, and that's because we need to hide that even from the render. Make sure you especially hide it from the render. And now if you play, you can see that it's happening. We're getting our scanning effect. Now let's make it better. I'm gonna make the end to 101. Let's make it better. Original, I'm gonna add in a material for each of these. I'm gonna move my light to about here so that I can see what's happening there. And I'm gonna go into the camera view. We're in the default camera view, by the way. I'm gonna go select our cube, go into the material, and I'm gonna add in and call this the default cube. I'm gonna make it something greenish maybe, and I'm gonna select the in between. I'm gonna give it a separate material and call it in between. I'm gonna delete the principal shader and add an emission shader, and the emission is gonna be like let's go here where we can see it and disable the overlays. I'm gonna add it, make the emission say bluish, but I want this to be darker, so gonna go dark like this and maybe a strength of 0.2. You'll see why in a moment. Now I'm gonna select our wireframe and add and give it a separate wheel and call it wireframe emission. Same emission material, and add in that techy color that you want, and I'm gonna increase the strength to 10, and you can see that we have that. Now you can disable. I'm gonna cut the world lighting, and also if you're using EV, you can enable blue, which will give you that sci-fi glow kind of thing. If you're not using EV, well, you will have to do it in compositing. I use cycles, so. And now that we have that, we can give it, we can preview it in E, because it's faster. Let's play that, and you can see that we have got our scanning effect happening there. And this is exactly what we need. Let's give it a render now. And here is my render. So if you like this video, or if this video helped you, please give it a thumbs up so that more people can find it. Let me know your ideas, let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and please consider giving my channel a subscribe, because it would really help me grow. And also share this video with someone you think would need this. So that's it for now. See you in another video. Bye.